across the river today with Coach Scott Martin on our next firing off with, brought to you by Jared's Tactical. Jared had a store full of people, so we moved it out to a beautiful location right near his store. Thank Jared's Tactical for allowing us to do another firing off with to begin with. And I bring in none other than Coach Scott Martin, who is a regular on our show. We do Mornings with Martin, which is the coach's show with Coach, and he's been on our show several times. And appreciate you coming on today, Coach.
Sure. Looking forward to it. I'll tell you what, anytime we can get out there and talk about football, that's always a good thing. And then, of course, I can't escape the lake.
That's your natural
habitat. That's my habitat.
That's it. Coach, I'm going to start, for those from Jerry's Tactical that will be seeing this that don't know you, talk about your career and how you actually came up, played college football, and was a kicker in college.
All right, well, I'm head football coach at Ohatchee now. I moved to Alabama about 13 years ago. About 13 years ago. And I retired out of Louisiana. I had 22 years coaching and teaching in Louisiana and retired out of Louisiana and moved to Alabama and started that second retirement. You know, when I grew up and I played all sports. I mean, I played football, I played basketball, I played baseball, I played golf. I did all of that stuff. Well, I just got the coaching itch when I got into, you know, I wanted to continue playing football. And I played some outside linebacker and kicked when I was in high school, but I kicked my whole career. So it was fun to be able to do that. And I ended up walking on at University of Louisiana Monroe, which at that time was Northeast Louisiana, and became a kicker. Set out a year, and then I kicked four straight years and set the school scoring record before I left. Of course, it's been broke since then. You know, people score a lot more points these days, but I was the career leading scorer when I left. And, you know, and I got that football itch, you know, that coaching itch when I was in college. The crazy thing about it was I took one semester where I thought I was going to go into, like, computer information systems, all right? Hey, you know, and made A's and B's, but I hated it. And went right back into coaching and got into coaching, started out as a GA at Northeast, and then now I'm in my 35th year of coaching.
And, Coach, how you came to Ohatchee is a very special story as well. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Well, I was at the golf tournament up at the Sunny King Golf Tournament and happened to
By the way, you're a scratch golfer.
Yeah, and I played golf in college, too. So that might have something to do with it. But I was playing in the Sunny King Golf Tournament, and I actually had a guy that was staying at the house I was staying at. I was in town as a guest, and he asked me if I could take him to a pool party after the tournament was over. Look, I was going back to Hoover and get ready for school the next day and or workouts the next day. And I said, sure, I'll take you over there. And it just so happened to be my future wife's house.
Awesome.
I met Shirley there at her house at the pool party. And I guess they'd say fate is fate from then on out. I mean, we've been inseparable, and we've been together 7 years now.
Coach, another very special story I'd like for you to share with everybody is how you came across your house. The M&M Paradise there, how you didn't even look at it, but you made an offer.
Right, well, you know, we happened to be driving looking for houses in the area. I was looking for a house, so I'd get out of Hoover and get over here. She was living in Sachs at the time. Well, I ended up going, we were driving down Virgil Drive, and we just made, and she said, let's drive farther down here. We kind of okayed that we were going to rent a house further up the road. Well, we ended up, she goes, well, let's just drive here and look. We found us for sale sign. By owner, of course. So we immediately call it. Boom. It went on the market the day before. Already two people ahead of me. So I told her, we'll never get this house. Well, about 2 days later, the lady calls me and says, look, Coach, it fell through. She said, you know, if you're still interested in coming to look at the house, let me know. I'd love for you to come by. And I said, we'll buy it. She said, no, Coach, I'm serious. If you want to come by and see the house. And I said, we'll buy it. She was like, but you've never seen the inside of it. So I don't care what it looks like inside. I've already seen enough on the outside and the setting that it was in. It's on 1.5 acres, and we've got almost 1,000 feet of water. And I said, we'll buy it. And so we basically bought the house unseen. I did satisfy her in the fact that I went to the house and looked at it. But, I mean, it didn't matter. I mean, and we walked through and said, okay, we'll buy it.
Man, you are a real estate agent's dream.
That's right.
But now, Coach, when you got to Ohatchee, it's not the Ohatchee that we know of as now. You've kind of built this machine. Talk about those early years there at Ohatchee when you got there.
Well, when I got there, they'd had 11 straight losing years, non-winning seasons. And that also had non-playoff seasons. So it was 11 straight years. The last time they'd been to the playoffs, I think it was 2003, when Coach Jeff Smith, who's now at Welborn, had led them to the playoffs a few years in a row. And so they'd been a dry spell since then. And so the main thing was they'd had coaches come in and leave, coaches come in and decide it wasn't for them. And there was a lot of different reasons. And I was at Hillcrest in Tuscaloosa, which was a big 6A school. And people were like, man, why would you leave Hillcrest? And I said, she's about 5'11". And she's blonde. Yes. But anyway, so I said, well, you know, I said, I've always, if you go back and look, and I think, you know, if you go back and look at my record overall from when I first started, I've always been intrigued with rebuilding programs. I've been, every school I've gone to hadn't been at the top of the ladder when I went there, with the exception of when I came to Alabama. Hillcrest had just had a couple of good years running. Calera had just had a couple of good years running. But for the most part, every program I've gone to has been a rebuilding situation. So I'm at the point in my career that I felt like to rebuild Ohatchee, you know, the first thing I did was, how much time are you going to give me? Because if you're only going to give me a year or 2 years and be dissatisfied because we're not winning, then save me the time from leaving a good job that I already have and coming here, because it's going to take a lot longer than just 2 years. And so they said, well, you know, you get tenured at 3 years in teaching. But I said, I'll tell you what, you give me 4 years. If you give me 4 years, at the end of 4 years, if you don't like where we're at, I'll leave. I won't tie you down. I won't stay on staff and limit who you can bring in or whatever. I said, at the end of 4 years, we'll make that decision. I said, I'll move on. I've moved on before. And as they would say, the first year we went 1-9, and we weren't very good. The next year, we had to find something that was going to work at Ohatchee. And us spreading the football and trying to deal it around, that worked to the tune of about 19 interceptions my first year. So we figured that ain't the way to go. So we happened to befriend a guy by the name of Paul Benefield at Fight. And because they were in a similar situation. I mean, Paul had always been successful at Fight, don't get me wrong. But he had turned the corner, and I wanted to see what he was doing that was different, because he had his geographical makeup, demographics, was a lot like ours at Ohatchee. So we went over there and visited Paul. He was gracious enough to let us watch him work out in the summer, and we got to see their summer workouts and got to watch them in the weight room. And, you know, we left there going, hey, you know what, we can do this. You know, we got to do a great job in the weight room. We got to do a great job with our kids, the discipline part of it. But we left with that little thing called the Ugly Eagle, too. And I'd been friends with Tim Murphy out in California before I'd ever met Paul. But I dabbled in a little double wing, double tight, but never into what Murphy had evolved to, which was the Ugly Eagle. So we got into that. We went 4-6 the first year, had a couple of games we could have won that we didn't win, but we still finished 4-6. And then, boom, wouldn't you know it, our third year we were 12-2. We lost to Piedmont in the regular season. We finished second to them, and we ended up losing them to them in the semifinals at their place, too. And they had a great team. They went on and won the state championship. But as I've said since then, we've kind of we hadn't looked back since then. I mean, we've been able to average 10 wins a season, you know, through the last 5 years. And, we've really turned a corner in that. But, you know, we've got loftier goals, and our goals are to get in the playoffs and make deep runs and try to win a state championship.
You know, you grant back-to-back region champs coming into this season. You're 25-3, I believe, in your last 28 games. And in this season, you're ranked number two in the state with literally a game that's lost right at the last second to Welborn. You built a machine, but it's not just known like here locally. It's all over the state. People know what you guys are and what you guys are about. But talk about, you know, your coaching staff that you put together there, because I noticed you give a lot of credit to those guys and always have, and it seems to be like you guys click together.
Well, you know, I'm fortunate enough that when I took that job, not only did I have some young coaches, which were just starting out and I guess kind of green behind the ears, but I had a mix of some older guys, but I had a group of guys that didn't want to leave Ohatchee, and that was key. You know, so many people, when you get into a losing situation, they're trying to find an assistance job somewhere else where they can have success, because they all want to be head football coaches or head coaches one day. Well, I mean, I was fortunate enough to get Blake Jennings was our defense coordinator now. Blake's been with me my whole time there.
Assistant coach of the year last
year? He was. He was the 2A assistant football coach of the year last year. Does a fantastic job on defense. I was worried. I mean, I got four guys that are all have Alexandria roots. Well, obviously, one of the things I was concerned about was, hey, they're all going to want to pack up and move back home.
Especially now that they're getting really good.
But the main thing that they all told me from the very beginning was, Coach, we want to go somewhere and do something where we're at, make a legacy for ourselves. You know, start a program, turn a program around, and not it be just because, you know, it's Alexandria boys going back to Alexandria. Alexandria has this tradition. They've been good. The credit probably doesn't go where it needs to go sometimes. So what I wanted it to do was, you know, establish our program, build our program, and be able to give credit to the guys that have helped build that program. And, you know, Blake Jennings has done that, obviously, with our defense. Chris Finley does it in the weight room. We've got Bryant Ginn, who works with our defensive backs, Brett Henderson, who works with our defensive line. Those guys have been with me for a while.
That's right.
I mean, there's not a lot of movement in those guys. Aaron Jackson's come on in the last – he's been with me now for a few years, and he's working my outside linebackers on the other side. Randall Tony does my running backs. Chris Finley, who does my weights, also does my quarterbacks. John Williamson does my offensive line. He's been with me every year with me except for my first year. You know, those guys now, you start looking at them, and then you got Cole Hurd, who's come on with me. He came on a few years ago, and he works with my tight ends. And then I've got two student assistants, Kevin Williamson, who played for me. And then I've got Dawson Green, whose dad used to be my sporting goods rep. So that's where we developed a relationship. Dawson and Kevin both go to JSU. So it's given us an opportunity to form a group of 11 guys, including myself, that have roots where we are. And, you know, we're not losing those guys. Now, to be honest with you, I'm worried every year, obviously, because they're good football coaches. But I think Calhoun County does such a great job of paying their assistants and paying their coaches that, you know, it would take a really special offer for one of those guys to leave us.
Absolutely. Now, a couple other things before we shut this video down, I want to talk about. One, this season, man, you guys have, you know, we moved back up to 3A now and literally are in the SEC West at 3A. Honestly, it is. I mean, it's a gauntlet every week. Sacks is your fourth place team and honestly could be region champs in a lot of 3A regions.
Yes, I agree.
No doubt about it. Moving back up to 3A, performing like you guys are, do you think your program's about where it needs to be at this moment, or are you still a step or two away from where you need to be? I know ever relaxes.
I mean, nobody ever relaxes. Right. I mean, we're excited to be where we are. But to be honest with you, until we, you know, it's never going to be complete until you can win a state championship. You know, you got to be honest with it. I mean, we've got teams that, I mean, that's hard to do. I mean, I won a state championship in Louisiana in the highest class as an assistant. But I'm just telling you, they're hard to win. I remember when we won it, I thought, man, this is easy. Man, we're going to win it every year. Man, we went 15-0. This is the easiest thing in the world. Well, you know, and then the year we went to the semifinals against Piedmont, I thought, man, we'll get back here. And then the next year we were 8-3. We lost in the first round. So, and then we went down to AA, and I felt like we had a couple opportunities there. And, you know, we had a couple of injuries that were inopportune times that didn't keep us from winning, but it sure made it difficult. And we weren't able to capitalize on those injuries or by having those injuries that hurt us. But we had a couple of scenarios where, you know, we had a chance when we played Fife, you know, back in 18, and we weren't able to get it done. And then last year in 19, we lost to Collinsville. Again, we had two major injuries toward the end of the season that really hurt us there. And so every year you've got to be able to have not only have a good football team, but you got to have some breaks along the way that go your way. And look, those coaches that win it, they'll tell you the exact same thing.
Absolutely.
That they still got to have breaks to win it along the way too, you know. So when I look out there and I see what Paul's done and I see what Steve Smith's done and they do it year after year after year, that's not as easy as it looks. You know, and Danny Horn and those guys, that's not as easy as it looks. And I don't care how good your players are, it's tough to mold those guys all together as one team. And, you know, I feel like going back to your original question, our program is I guess, getting the notoriety that maybe it deserves. That doesn't mean a whole lot to me because I'm just looking at each game and each year and trying to make it the best I can make it. But, you know, I'm excited for where we're at. I'm excited for the publicity that our kids get, for the, you know, recognition that they get. They've worked awful hard. So it is nice to have that happen for them.
Yeah, we can go in. I mean, we've been in 7A schools, 6A schools, covering them before, and they'll ask us questions about what's the difference in Ohatchee and Fife, and what's the difference in Ohatchee and Piedmont, and what are they doing at Ohatchee? You know, we've watched Mornings with Martin all year. Yeah. I was in a 5A school last week. It was like, man, I watched that show just because cool coach. Dude seems laid back, chill. I was like, he's pretty chill. now, outside of staying healthy, what do you think it's going to take to turn that corner and get that first state championship at Ohatchee?
Well, again, let's go back. Breaks, obviously. But, you know, you're going to have to win some big games in the playoffs. You know, that's the one thing that, you know, we won a big game at Lauderdale County in the playoffs back in 16. We won a big game against Randolph County in the playoffs back in 16. You know, I don't think we've won the big game in the playoffs since then. But, you know, the way it stacks up this year, you got to win a big game. Obviously, the way the bracket's going to stack up with Piedmont on one side, and then you've got Fife and Welburn and us all on the other side. And like I said, Lauderdale County's, we're going to play them the first round. It's almost crazy because we're 9-1, or I'm sorry, we're 8-1 at this point. They're 8-1 at this point. We both play this week. We're both region champions that tied, but we lost in the playoff, in the tiebreakers. So, in that first round, you've got a 2 and a 3 that are really a 1 and a 1 playing each other, and possibly both of them could be 9 and 1 at that time.
That's insane. And it's insane how they do the tiebreakers, too. I mean,
and so, I mean, you go through there. I mean, we're going to play a region champion the first round, and then, like you've already said, we got to go through these other big boys. Yeah. And now I will say, I think that our region, and the toughness of our region, especially the way our schedule was, where it was front end loaded, and we had to play back to back to back to back, our kids are not going to be like taken back that, hey, we got a tough game, then a tough game, then a tough game, then a tough game. But I will tell you, the toughest game is always the first game. It really is. In the playoffs, the toughest game is always the first game because it's the one that if you don't win it, you go home. And they're all like that. But for some reason, it's always getting past that first round is always one of those, whoop. All right, now let's go. I mean, it's the way it works out.
It's the narrative of you're looking ahead, we're in the playoffs, we should steamroll these
and
games.
Everybody always says, oh, they should win that one easy. Yeah. Well, I'm going to just tell you, that one we got this first round, you know, we went over there in 16 and beat them up pretty good, and I promise you they hadn't forgot that.
Oh, no, they're going to be ready.
Yes.
But, you know, you said it first. I'm going to say this. That first half of your schedule this season, geez, coach, sacks. Then you turn around and you play Welburn. And you turn around and play Anniston, who made the semis last year in 4A. Yeah. Then Piedmont. Yeah. And then Hoax Bluff, who was in the semis 2 years ago in 4A. I was like, geez.
It was very front-end loaded, and we weren't sure what to expect. And, you know, to come out of that thing
healthy,
right? Pretty healthy, and only have one loss and it being overtime, you know, I felt like, you know, we were basically one touchdown away from being obviously as good as we could be.
It's unbelievable. Coach, good luck to you guys this season. I appreciate you sitting in. I know Jared really appreciates you, and everybody from Ohatchee who has not visited Jared's Tactical right here over the bridge from the front and into Rainbow City.
Yeah, right there across from Little Bridge Marina.
That's right. Recently burnt down, unfortunately, Little Bridge Marina, but all the fine people of Ohatchee that needs to come up and check this place out. It's a very cool story he's got here. Coach, we really appreciate your time, and I know you got to go get your boat out of the water because we have a Hurricane Z. It's already up to the Z's now.
That's right.
Heading this way. All right, Coach. Thank you so much.